Now we spend all our time out in nature. You get very intimate with the world. And over time, if you're living that life, you start to sense that everything has a spirit. There's a consciousness in everything. Everything is alive. If everything is alive, then we want to respect it. And if we're going to use it, we want to use it respectfully.
What I try to tell my nephews and nieces, you know, you love to hunt, you have to take care of the animals that you catch, preparing the food and eating the food that you catch.
Water provides you. The ice brings you life. It provides all those things that you need to be a part of your life.
That was something I grew up with. I grew up respecting the animals. I grew up respecting the land. And that, to me, that is why we as an Inupiaq culture, as an Inupiaq people, is why we're so successful.
In, you know, Arctic Alaska, hunting is a really important part of life. It's not just about going and shooting something, it's about going and putting food on the table.
Thank you. I think most central to the ideology of the Inupiat is the idea of sharing.
Being able to feed the community, feed others. That's why we hunt, you know. In the old days, that's what you needed to survive, you know.
The sharing is important because it's how the community survives together, collectively.
We just give. That's how I grew up. That's the way I'm always gonna be. Because of who we are, we always think about other people first.
If our people didn't share in, you know, in the old days, we wouldn't have survived in this harsh, you know, climate, environment.
Berg siaro logolo tegan neagalo suflo gaik akobegom kingamegom suflo gaik akobegom silamon ila katak tuak silamon tipine gaik sanganut nunaken.
Big Timid, Little Timid, and King Island. And in those three islands are the stepping stones to get to America.
So King Island is this absolutely beautiful place off the coast of Alaska. And if you can imagine being on this really kind of rocky island that kind of shoots up from the water to these cliffs. And then all of a sudden you see these stilts, and then you look up and there are these houses.
They were built on the cliff up high because of the ice. Being an island in the Bering Sea, you have ice that's being pushed by the winds onto the island. So it's gonna pile up 50, 60 feet high. Structures are still there today, and people have returned to King Island. It's a growing community as the people return back to their island.
Damna nunakek inyit kinganyaksa. Tainap taak pingabulugo, ibiak siyagrolum ay magbiyatun. Kigoyat kau maktit kat nunaket.
When I was young, my mom, whenever the Northern Lights came out, she just whistle.
Boy, they come alive. Just keep whistling and that aurora will just like, you know, you can almost hear it.
And then she explained to me a little bit later that those are children and children who've passed away when they were children. You don't want to draw them in too much, you know, is what she said, because then they could play football with your head, play Eskimo football, and that's what they want to do. They're always playing, those children up there.
Don't play out without your hood on. If you don't have your hood on, the Aurora person is going to come down and chop your head off and play ball with your head.
It wasn't like they were trying to do bad, you know, or it was like a scary story or anything like that. It was just, that's how it was, that's what it was.
Kirwayat siliagahutin silamin. Ibahaliksut nalakanilay tiyonik. Kirwayat siliagahuting silamin. Ibahaliksut nalakanilay tiyonik. Tukkanan.
In the month of November, there's no sun. So during that dark time, we travel by the light of the moon. It's quite different. Everything was silver and black. Toward the horizon, we could see where caribou are because their body heat flowing upward, and we could see it glowing in the moonlight against a dark horizon where there's no stars. If somebody yelled, you could know who yelled from where the sound came from, but specifically for that cloud of their breath went up and it glowed in the moonlight. So that was a good time to travel. It was very surrealistic. And so things that were dark objects looked very close, and white objects looked very far.